everyone, and welcome back to the Fairy Tale Family, where our goal is to put a little bit of magic into your everyday. I'm Chelsea, and today we are talking about spring cleaning and spring self-care. So we live in New England, where it very literally snowed yesterday, despite the fact that we are in almost the second week of March. So today, gorgeous, sunny, 60 almost. It's New England. For those of you who live in warmer or more temperate climates, you may be experiencing spring a bit earlier than this video is going out to you. However, I have been in the mindset, despite cold, despite the snow, that spring is coming. March is the hopeful month for me. And I know that in my teaching profession, oftentimes March is seen as this evil entity because it's in between two breaks. There's this 6-week stretch of just relentless pain, it seems like. But I use that time to try to get in the mindset of we're gonna clean, we're gonna refresh, we're gonna make everything as white and bright as we possibly can before we get into what is my very favorite season, summertime. So what I wanted to do in this video is show you how I spring cleaned my closet. Now, this is part of a bigger list of spring self-care that you can find in the description box below. I wrote a blog post on a couple of tips for how I do spring self-care, and one of those tips is about cleaning out my closet. Now, I do this every year no matter what, but this year the closet clean was way more intense than normal because of the nature of my weight loss journey. So if you're new here, hi, welcome. I've lost about almost 80 pounds since July. I did have weight loss surgery. I'll link those videos here above for you. But because of that, my sizes have been super inconsistent and I needed to get rid of a lot of things. So you'll also see me making piles. This is a very unedited raw footage series of a room in our house, of our closet room. Now we did convert a small bedroom into a closet. So if you're thinking this is not a closet space, it is. It's just not closet doors, like it's not a typical closet, but it does mean it gets really messy super quickly with laundry piles and surfaces to put things on. So when you're seeing the very beginning of this video, you'll see all of that. And then at the end, I kind of do like a panoramic of it. So my other spring self-care tips are going to be in a blog post in the description, and there's also a freebie within that blog that is kind of a checklist for you. And some of these items are going to cost you something. Like one of my spring self-care items is doing a subscription service for yourself or purchasing something that makes you happy. And for me, that's FabFitFun. So I'll also link those other videos here. And I do have a discount in that sheet for you as well, and that kind of cheat sheet. And some things like cleaning out your closet are going to cost you nothing and they might make you money. So you'll notice in the upcoming closet clean out that I do like part Poshmark and part consignment sales, where my clothing goes to a consignment store. And then I also do like a huge donation pile for clothing that has been a little more well loved. So today really is about the closet spring clean out. Now, hopefully you can take this video with you, plop it in your closet and just like get to work. Otherwise, this might just be inspiration for you, but I would recommend that you check the blog post out. It's not long, but it does give you what I'm doing in the next few weeks or so to kind of like perk up my life a little bit. And I think that self-care is one of the most magical ways to make every day feel for you special. So that's kind of it. If you want to watch me clean out my very messy closet, keep on watching. So our closet is actually now, okay, so it's really messy and I don't want to show it to you, but I'm going to. Our closet is divided into two sections. There's our washer and dryer, and it walks straight through. I know it's glary because of the window, but that is our master bedroom in there. So this is my side of the closet, and I kind of break it up by item. Stuff in the middle. And then this is also my side. And then shamefully, this is like my shoe section, which equally needs cleaning out. And then that bin right there, that little gray guy, is also full of shoes. So there's some serious shoe needs here. This is Mark's side. A lot of Hawaiian going on here. I don't know what's going on with these pants. I'm not going to clean anything or touch anything that belongs to Mark. So we kind of have like a we do our own laundry situation. We both do Callie's laundry. We both do laundry for the house, like towels and rugs and things like that. But when it comes to our own clothing, we prefer that the other doesn't touch it. So just so you're aware, I'm not neglecting this. I don't know what he's doing. So I'm not going to touch that. Okay. So this is going to be some sped up clips. I'll probably slow you down, show you what I'm getting rid of. That's kind of it. But we're just really hoping that this inspires you to do your own version of spring clean. And we hope you enjoy. Thanks for following along. Okay, so I am starting in one corner of my closet and I'm pulling everything out to either try on or toss on the floor, and I'm deciding which piles are going to be for selling and for donating as I'm pulling things out. So I'm being really thorough in one section at a time, and I'm refolding everything in my drawers. So now I'm going over to my pants section because this is the second largest part of my wardrobe. And I'm doing the same exact process. I'm pulling everything out. I'm hanging up new things. I'm tossing stuff onto the floor. And I'm working upwards. I've decided that I need to elongate how I do my long sleeve shirts. So instead of it being in one section of my closet, it'll now be in two. So now I'm on the floor and I have my piles. And I'm trying to figure out what's worthy of being sold. And because I go through a local consigner, I am typing everything into the computer at one time, the item's description, how much I think it's worth, what I want to sell it for, and then I'm bagging it all up. Now I have made my way into our bedroom because I had bigger items that I wanted to evaluate, and I have clearly gone on to shoes. So don't forget about your shoes when you're doing your cleaning and purging. This is what the closet looks like now. I have these 3.5 bags to go to donation or be sold, and you can see how much more space I've made in the closet, which I'm thrilled about. And it just feels so much better. So my friends, that is it for the closet clean out. There will be upcoming photos coming to Instagram. I am in search of the perfect like inserts for that little organizer that connects the pieces of our closet. And I just can't find any that I seem to love. So more of those little boxes will be coming, and I think that'll really tidy up that area. But keep an eye out on Instagram for those. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe. We really appreciate our subscribers. We'll have more Disney and Aulani content coming to you in the month of March and beyond. But we thought this would be a nice time to do a little refresh for yourself and your house and the people you love. So that's it. Make sure you check out the blog post below, and I hope you have a magical day. Bye, friends.